Did you know that if your web page doesn't load in under 3 seconds, 53% of your visitors will likely abandon your site? Now, let me say that again. That's 53%. That's over half of your potential client base gone forever if your pages don't load in less than 3 seconds. But let's imagine that some of those visitors decide to stay around and browse your site a little bit. Almost 80% of those visitors will never return if they experience any trouble at all loading your page while browsing your site. Now, that is a super demanding audience. And it will only get worse. As tech companies promise to get faster and faster performance, the expectations of the general public will only get higher and higher. So how can you make sure that your site is up to par and be sure that you're not missing out on all those potential clients? By monitoring your site. Monitoring is a vague term for overseeing, tracking, and reviewing a system's performance. Depending on what type of monitoring tool you use, you can get valuable information about system uptime, memory, CPU performance, and so much more. If you want to stay competitive in today's market, and tomorrow's market as well, you need to be using a monitoring tool. But which monitoring tool, you might ask? Basically, there are only two types of monitoring tools: synthetic monitoring and real user monitoring. But what's the difference? Synthetic monitoring, also known as synthetic testing, is an active way of monitoring your website. You actively test the performance and response time with scripts that simulate the path an end user will take throughout your site. To incorporate synthetic monitoring into your development workflow, you can use tools like Sematext Synthetics, Google Lighthouse, Web Page Test, and Pingdom. Synthetic monitoring has been a golden standard in testing and monitoring for a long time, mainly because it gives a clean testing environment for developers. Developers need synthetic monitoring to make sure that the changes they make to their website's code are actually improving the performance of their site and not hindering it. So essentially, we want no external variables, only robots here, no humans or user-side errors to mess things up. If the synthetic test detects a problem with performance after a commit is made, you can be sure that the issue is on your side of things and not the client. The advantage of synthetic testing is that it offers a controlled environment where every test is a constant and the only variable is the actual code of the website. Also, these synthetic monitoring tools can be used to run periodically and repetitively, giving you up-to-date information about your site's performance. This gives developers insight into whether their changes improve or hinder the performance of the website. So what are the pros of synthetic monitoring? They allow you to run dedicated tests in a clean environment. You get data from multiple locations across the globe and around the clock. You can catch bugs before the users experience them, you can benchmark competitors to see how you stack up against them, and you can test and monitor literally every part of your site individually. Synthetic monitoring sounds great, right? So what's missing? Well, there is no real human input, and this can cause site administrators to be blind to certain UI or UX issues that real users on your site are having. This is where real user monitoring tools come into play. Real user monitoring, sometimes called RUM or digital experience monitoring, is a passive type of monitoring that analyzes real user data and tracks their experience and journey throughout your website. Unlike synthetic monitoring, which uses scripts to test, real user monitoring takes data from real users and their devices on your actual site. This gives you insight into how real customers are interacting with your real website. Real user monitoring analyzes everything from page load events to HTTP requests to front-end application crashes. Real user monitoring tools let you see everything that is happening in the real world, from HTTP requests, crashes, timeouts, and even AppDex scores that give you insight into your user satisfaction with your product or service. All of this data can give you a clearer picture into how your application is performing in the real world with real users. This in turn can help you and your team create a better user experience, which helps reduce bounce rates, convert customers faster, and reduce churn rates. Many people think they don't need a monitoring tool because they use Google Analytics. Google Analytics does a great job at tracking certain types of interaction between your user and your website. It can track page views, click paths, browser types, and traffic sources. However, it doesn't collect the necessary data you need to easily assess your user's overall satisfaction. When you want to collect data that directly relates to your user's experience, you need a real user monitoring tool. So, synthetic versus real user monitoring, which one should you use? Actually, it's not an either-or type of problem. Both are great tools designed for different things. That's like asking which is better, a hammer or a screwdriver. Both of these tools are great when used together and can help you create and maintain something great. So get a full tool belt with all the tools you need at Sematext. Sematext is a flexible monitoring system that helps you detect and troubleshoot production and performance issues with synthetic and real user monitoring, all in one place. Check it out today for free. The link for that is down in the description below. Like and subscribe if you found this video helpful, and until next time, keep monitoring, everybody.